Hi guys, myself and Romain are back. It's time for more night models.
Yay!
And we're back onto the Batman miniatures game.
Oh, yes. Yes,
and
yes, yes.
And this time we're on to...
The Joker.
And his goons.
Yes.
Lots of goons.
God. I love him. I love that version. I the Heath Ledger version is legendary and great and all that, but...
Yes. It's hard to beat the old comic book version.
Exactly.
Well, let's pop open the big blister, because this is one of the starter sets.
Yep.
So you get your main villain and some henchmen to actually let you get stuck in. So we'll get on to the bits.
Yeah.
So put that out of the way. So, goon number one. He's a bald guy.
Oh, yeah. He's
slightly
called
pudgy.
Clown.
So this is Clown.
This is Clown.
Are we sure this is Clown?
This is Clown.
Yes, we're sure this is Clown.
We're sure this is Clown.
Yep. Very, very nice sculpt. Mm-hmm. And it's not just one of these buff henchmen.
I love the detail of the hand. You know, he's really, he's come closer, you know.
Yes, it's just that pose. I am ready for you with
exactly.
my big ass machete.
Among other things.
Yep. We have.
Does he have. Yes, in the little bag here,
he
has a weapon.
We'll get to this in a second. Mm. We have the next of our goons, who is wearing a hoodie.
Oh, yes. That is Contra Augusta.
Contra Augusta? Mm. Very highfalutin name for a grunt. And he's rocking about with a baseball bat.
Yeah.
But again, great detail. The mask is quite plain on the actual miniature, but a little bit of freehand work, you know, perfect for getting started.
Absolutely. The makeups on these is going to be a really, really good training for those who want to do faces and the like. This is really, really good.
We have the last goon.
And even though they're in sweaters and sweatpants and, you know, crappy. This is a ringmaster, by the way. Even though they're in crappy clothes, you know, they are very detailed clothes, nonetheless.
Yeah. You know. Yeah, he looks as if he's sort of a commander, I would say, with the biggest hat.
But he's the ringmaster, the master of ceremonies.
Yes.
And, you know,
and his armor actually looks a bit homebrewed, which I like. So it's not perfectly clean and such. It's
something made with anti-riot things and cushions.
Yep, and possibly. He then has the big chain running down his leg.
Yeah.
More armor plate around the back. It looks like repurposed SWAT armor. We then have the body for the Joker. So we have him here. Again, he's single piece in the body.
Yeah.
He's very tall, very, very slim.
Gangly, and he looks like he's advancing on like on a stage, you know.
Yes.
Like so, with his feet right in front of one another instead of...
Right, let's get on to the little bits.
It's a very studied walk.
We have our baseball bat.
Yep.
Which is a classical weapon for one of Joker's goons. We have this, which looks to be a bit of a cape for someone.
No, it's the tail of the Joker's suit.
Ah, I see it. Mm. We have the Joker's head himself. Wow.
Yep.
Detailed to hell.
Exactly. Very, very pointy.
Yes, we have a little bit of something with a chain on it here.
I think that's the chain for the ringmaster.
Yep, we have a goon's blade.
Yeah, it's a butcher's knife. Mm, yep. Lovely.
We have one of the ringmaster's arms.
Yeah.
I think, yes, that goes with the ringmaster. So mm-hmm. The rest is the Joker.
Yeah.
So he has a little shiv.
Exactly. He has a
teeny, weeny, tiny little potato peeler.
Always fun at parties.
So here's what the painted version looks like. And it's just such a classic view of an iconic villain.
Yeah, that's the one from the game. He's a little older, but he's really, really creepy.
Yeah, but it's been done so, so nicely. Because you have all the detail there. You've got the old battered purple suit, the stained shirt, the little green bow tie. Mm. Is a perfect representation of one of my favourite villains.
Really, really amazing.
So we'll move all the goons and such out the way.
Yeah.
What's next?
Ooh. The Titan Clown. It is the Joker Titan Clown.
Okay. So as we all know, the Titan Project from the video games made essentially Bane, who wasn't Bane. So you could have him in all of the different factions.
Yep. And different flavours of Banes.
Yes. So, oh, he is a big dude.
Wow. That is big. That is big. Even for that sort of base, it's... Yeah.
Yep. So we have his main body with his head.
Yep.
And whatever
tiny, tiny head.
Yes, little tiny head down beneath the shoulders. Very classic comic book.
Oh, he has a bow tie.
Big veins sticking out of the arms.
Yep.
And just rips and stuff running through the clothing. So mm-hmm. he has just been dressed normally and been buffed up.
Well, normally. Dressed as a clown still, but...
Mm. Yes. We then have the running leg.
He has the clown, hairdo. Bald head and hairdo. That's absolutely creepy.
So we have the running legs all torn and ripped to hell.
Mm-hmm.
And he actually still has his coattails on, which I think is quite funny.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah, and barefoot, obviously, because your shoes could never stick up to be turned into a titan.
Yeah.
We then have his other big, meaty arm. Great musculature detail
actually,
on that.
Yeah, absolutely. And let's see. Yeah. His fist is...
bigger than his head.
Twice as big as his head, actually.
Which is, again, a classic comic book trope for a bruiser.
Exactly.
You know, the...
Oh my god, the hugeness of the muscles everywhere.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's what we're seeing with these. They're very much following the old comic book tropes. Because whenever it's a crusher type character,
mm-hmm.
hands are bigger than the head. They're really broad. The head's down low.
Yes, it's caricatured. It's exaggerated. It's absolutely wonderful.
Yeah, whenever it's say the Joker, it's that very long, gangly mastermind sort of look.
Yes, all the good villains. It's a stick figure with a big head because. Yes. There's the mind.
Equals yeah. very smart.
Exactly.
Right, now the last one. I've been waiting for this one to get my hands on it. Please give her to me now. Give her to me now. Thank you. We have
you deserved it.
Harley Quinn. Now, she is the video game version, but I like the video game version more than the actual comic book version.
Yeah, actually, she started out in the series, the... Batman series from the way back when, you know, like Paul Dini and
oh right,
that sort of thing. She started out as a character in the animated series.
I see.
And they brought her to life in the comic book afterwards.
I see.
But she is a great character.
So we have her little baseball bat, which has been painted up to be essentially a candy cane.
Mm.
And then we have the mini itself. So it's a two-piece sculpt with the little pigtails and everything. Mm. Beautifully done.
I can't help but thinking she would look better with a huge hammer, because that's how I always imagine her.
Mm.
But she looks great.
You know? Yeah, she looks great, and it's again, it's going to be another one that's going to be really, really fun to paint.
Oh, yeah.
You know, because even down to her little corset, they've went into the detail of actually sculpting lots of little buttons and the different mm-hmm. segments of it.
Absolutely. So it's a Harley Quinn really fun. Fashion, you know, that is really, really cool.
Yeah.
Really cool to paint. Actually, this is a sculpt that is a bit old now, a few years.
It's yeah. at least 1 year, because I saw it last year while we were still in England.
Yeah.
But even for being an older sculpt, it doesn't matter. The guys
oh, no, it doesn't matter at all.
Models mm-hmm. are superb at what they do. You know,
this is just to say that this is a successful miniature.
Yes, it's very because successful.
It really is very good.
Like honestly, I'm kind of torn at the minute, guys, because we are going to take some of these home, build them, paint them, and then learn to play the game. This would be what I'd be very tempted to take, simply because I love Harley Quinn, I love the Joker,
yeah,
and I love the insanity of their characters.
Mm.
But... we'll have to wait and see. I think we'll move on here.
You do need good guys too. I mean,
oh, of course.
But the villains are so good.
Yes, it's yes, but it's always fun to play the bad guys, and even the bad guys can fight the other bad guys.
Yeah,
you're messing with my plan. How about no?
Perfect.
Anyway, myself and Roman are going to move on here. We're going to see what else we can find before he heads home to Paris, and we'll see you in the next video.
Bye.